Hola fam, and welcome to another episode of Latina Geek. So far we've learned many of things and the tragedies of this family. If for whatever reason you stumbled across this video, this is, I believe, episode 4 of 1. So go ahead and go back to the first one, because I don't want to spoil anything for you. But we are playing What Remains of Edith Finch. We learn about the sad ending to this 1-year-old, and we have about, I believe, 4 characters left to find out what is going on in this house. Also, most importantly, our character, the character that we are playing as we're going through this game, is 22 weeks pregnant, so that might factor into something at the end. Alright, let's hop to it.
A poem for Gus, who always said the wedding was a bad idea. Our father never hit us kids, at least not very hard, before the day my brother said with teenage disregard that he'd be dead before he'd see a wedding in our yard.
This is really pretty. Ruining it, guys, I'm ruining it.
My father made him come, of course, but Gus stood far apart, just flew his kite and bottled up the storm inside his heart. I tried to talk him out of it, but though he'd never met me, we don't need a stepmom, were the words that
I now pronounce you husband and wife.
We're at a wedding. We're not too happy about having a stepmom, which is something I completely understand. Totems are creepy.
When the time for photos came, Dad ordered him to come here. But Gus declined, and as a sign, held up his middle finger.
Oh, badass little kid.
The wind picked up, and panicked geese appeared and quickly went. But all the humans did that day was go inside the tent.
Oh, no. I'm gonna get electrocuted, aren't I? That's where these children are just fated to go.
The rain came down in buckets then, but no one seemed afraid that nature might destroy the tent our dad had crudely made.
Oh, that's not good. Alright. This looks grim, guys.
Thunder sounded much too close and full of angry power. But all my father said to this was, make the music louder.
Oh, no. Lightning and thunder is no joke when you live on an island, guys. Me.
wish that I could truly say I thought about you on that day. Out there on the beach alone, just you, the wind, the sea, and foam. But I didn't. Until we found you.
Oh, sad. All right.
She never talked about him, but Mom told me once if I was a boy, they were going to name me Gus.
For a kid? What a cruel, cruel world. What a cruel house. Oh, man. Okay. Everything so far in this game is definitely unexpected. Like, I didn't expect to see the way that all these people died. Or, wow.
My mom moved up to the loft after her brothers died. At the time, it was as far away as she could get.
That seems like a lot of work, guys. I think her mom might be the only person alive.
She spent a summer building houses in Calcutta, where she met my dad, Sanjay.
Aww.
Religion was another thing my mom never talked about. But I think it helped her a lot after her dad died.
How on earth did they get furniture up there if they didn't have... Okay, alright, alright. So, we went that way. We want to... exit somehow. Anything I miss? No. No. It's almost spookier knowing you have the whole house to yourself. Just this giant memorial to people. I've gone the other way. Probably. Okay. I lost my guides.
Sam spent his life shooting photos, but Mom said he got nervous being in front of the camera.
There we go.
I guess we're all afraid of something.
There we go. It's like nothing's being prompted, guys. Help! Okay. Let's see. That looked like a person over there for a second. Okay, I guess outside we go. Nope, we go all the other way. There we go. Okay, I totally missed that.
My mom moved to India a week after graduation and got a job teaching English. Lewis was born a year later. When my dad died, I don't think Mom knew where else to go. I'm sure Edie was happy to have her back. And to see kids in the house again.
That is heartbreaking. This family has been through it, guys.
The house had to get a little bigger, but Edie was used to that. And for a while, things were good. Almost normal.
It's a little homeschool. That's cute.
But it didn't last. The beginning of the end was Milton's 10th birthday, when Edie gave him a castle.
Oh no.
After Milton disappeared, the only thing he left behind was a room full of paintings.
This has to be one of the coolest rooms, but also one of the saddest rooms.
I think finally have another painter in the family.
Wait, is he not dead? There's no end date.
Milton Finch in The Magic Paintbrush.
Oh. Oh, he disappeared. Okay. So you don't know if he's dead. You just know he's gone. Which, given this family's history, he might as well be dead. Alright. You can see he works in mostly blacks and whites. Alright, down, down, down we go.
Mom spent months searching for my brother. Then she sealed the doors. Milton had found in the house. Mom didn't want it getting out.
What's scarier is the fact that she's bringing her fetus with
Mom
her.
Mom definitely blamed Edie, but I think Lewis blamed himself. After he graduated, he just spent more and more time in his room until Mom got him a job at the cannery.
No, we're opening this. Let's do this. There we go. Bada bing. We're very, very close to the end, you guys. And I don't really know what to expect.
This room smelled very, very familiar. That part of him lived on.
Blaze it. It's a really cool room, though.
Dear Mrs. Finch, as Lewis's psychiatrist, I can understand your desire for an explanation. As I see it, the trouble began in January. Shortly after we convinced your son to seek treatment for substance abuse. Newly sober, I believe Lewis first noticed the monotony of his daily life. He kept working at the cannery. But he withdrew part of himself. Our sessions, I saw the same behavior. His mind began to...
Wander? Oh, whoa.
I asked him to describe it. He said he started small. Imagining a labyrinth. He'd feel his way about. Then something moved. Back.
Well, this is really hard to do. I'm trying to do these at the same time.
Things that have not names. He knew it was all in his head.
Fishes are piling up, guys.
I had hoped he'd find himself. He found something more. I worried about him then. Daydreaming at the cannery.
He's gonna lose his arm.
I spoke with his boss. But he said Lewis had become a model employee. Methodical, tireless, focused. A whole new Lewis. So I let him go on. I even encouraged him.
So yeah, I'm moving the fish.
It seemed very promising.
I'm moving this guy. It's not a very wise idea, actually.
He told me he'd made a new friend. On the edge of a city he named Lewis Topia. He built the city up slowly, brick by brick.
What a guy! What a guy! It's one of my drummer guys!
Then he made musicians.
Woohoo! This is much happier!
Songs for them to play. He talked about starting a band.
Turn up. Is there guys just humming around?
Every day his imagination grew stronger.
Uh-oh.
He no longer spoke at the cannery. But his chopping was as reliable as ever. Then one day it struck him.
Uh-oh.
That all the cheering crowds, even the stones under his feet, his imagination, so he could do whatever he wished.
Oh, there we go, there's my red carpet.
He held an election for men. And he won.
Unanimous vote. Woo-hoo.
They begged him to stay, but his mind was already wandering. It became a game for him.
Uh-oh, do you notice how the scenery is getting wider?
He'd conquer a city, then immediately push on. New Louisville. St. Louis. He started drifting away from our reality. Minneapolis. Huh? Until one day he forgot to go home from the cannery.
Uh-oh.
Even as his mother pleaded with him, part of Lewis kept sailing on.
Just gonna die from exhaustion?
In Lewisburg, he heard rumors of a quest for
sinister serpents.
Sinister serpents.
Adventure. Steering this boat is hard. There you go.
He followed the sound of his
silver harp.
Silver harp.
My fingers are falling asleep from that salmon action. Take that as you will.
His chase led him to a golden palace east of the sun and west of the moon.
La la.
Even then, his logic remained sound. He knew the world was all in his imagination.
So yeah. Guys. I have to mind my hair.
He was so proud of having created it.
Oh shit.
In his own eyes, he'd become something greater than a king. Someone who'd never known success in the real world, I think it was overwhelming.
Yes, yes, hello.
That the real Lewis was not the one chopping salmon, but the one climbing the steps of a golden palace.
I like that they slowed down the fish. With good reason.
My imagination is as real as my body, he told me. Hard to argue with him.
Whoa, that was an awesome transition. All right. Huh.
Began to forget the world we know. I think it pained him to remember Lewis, the cannery worker.
Are we finally seeing a human being, or are we just in a flashback?
He began to despise the man with a royal contempt.
I haven't been chopping anything anymore. I'm just moving stuff along. Alright. I'm gonna stare. Where do I go from here? What's happening? What's happening?
I still thought I could save him. even after he said he was being crowned king over all the lands of wonder.
Just lost his mind. On to us again. Hey, cool.
The palace would be packed with his companions.
Hey guys. Today's the day, huh? Looking good, Henry. Daddy, did you lose weight? It's my day. I win. Woo! Look at that guy. He's having fun.
Including the wise Calico, who insisted on advising me.
I would have a cat as my royal vizier. Wise Calico. It's lit, fam. I can't rush it. This is the pace I gotta walk, guys. Thank you. Good to see you.
Holding his crown.
My body is ready for this coronation.
I think you know.
Oh no.
Mrs. Finch, your son was a kind man who will be missed by all of us who knew him.
He killed himself at the... Oh my god. Well?
My brother was really cool. I wish you could have met him.
Wow, guys. I think we have... We have Evie and Sven left. We're gonna push through. I guess one more death. Is everybody cool with that? There's just so many things left unanswered, and why is there a whole house dedicated to this? There's so many things that we don't know yet. We know how people died and why people died, but we don't know why there's a whole house dedicated to
it. My mom told me to start packing. She waited until the day before we left to tell Edie. I'm not sure if she wanted to make it easier or harder. I wish we'd stayed. But I understand why we left. What happened that night had been coming for a long time. Maybe it should have come sooner.
I have a feeling we're entering into Edith territory. Yeah.
But it had to end one way or another. All that's left now is to tell you about that last night.
Here we go, kids.
Last day, Edie just watched us pack and didn't say a word. Until supper, when she raised her glass and said,
"To our final night together, and all our final nights apart."
Grandma, you know what I said about alcohol. Some of your medications are very specific.
I left a present for you in the hallway. Why don't you go open it? The grown-ups have to argue now.
I'm sorry, you're right. We're all leaving tomorrow. Let's just enjoy our last...
I'm not leaving.
Edith, you're excused.
Who? I wish my parents had done that. Like, just open it on us. Hey, we're gonna argue now. Just go ahead and do your kid thing.
The power had been shut off that morning, but Edie always had plenty of candles. When my mom sealed the library, I don't think she knew about the other entrance. Or that Edie had a key to it.
Oh god, we're gonna find out, guys. What the hell is going on?
thing you're afraid of isn't going to end when you leave the house. Edith has a right to know these stories.
My children are dead because of your stories.
Oh,
I think it's best if Edith and I leave tonight. We'll have the nursing home send a van for you in the morning.
Oh.
Okay.
Dear Edith, there's so many stories I wish I could tell you, but there's only time for one. This is about what happened on the night you were born. That night, the tide went way, way out.
Uh-oh. You know what that means, right, guys? If you don't, might want to catch up on your National Geographic, my dudes.
Never saw the old house aground.
Ah, okay, I see stairs. This game is very picky about where you get to go. There you go. See? There's that light indicator.
There'd been an earthquake out in the middle of the ocean.
Uh-oh.
They called it the lowest tide in 1,000 years. God, it smelled awful. No, I've seen that house every day of my life. But I never thought I'd go back to it. When the fog rolled in, lost my way. I got turned around.
Oh no.
For a while, I wandered. Seeing things. Things I'd forgotten had ever existed. But when I saw them, they felt like old friends. That night, a lot of things came back to me. Maybe I came back to them.
How did this end up in the middle of the sea? That's still tripping me out.
Things I can't explain, but that I need you to try and...
Edith, what are you doing in here?
It's mine.
Edith!
Mom, you're gonna rip it, let go!
I kicked and screamed, but... Mom dragged me to the car. I never saw Great Grandma Edie again.
Oh.
The next morning, the band came to pick her up, but she was already gone. After that, we moved around a lot. We both tried to make the best of it. A few years went by. My mom didn't like to talk about it. But she started getting sick a lot. rest happen pretty quickly. She got better for a while, and then she didn't. And then I was alone. The last Finch left alive. Until I found out about you.
Baby!
I'm still not sure what to tell you about all this.
Who's the father?
If we lived forever, maybe we'd have time to understand things. But as it is, I think the best we can do is try to open our eyes and appreciate how strange and brief all of this is.
Oh, I guess we're going, are we going out of the womb? Is that what's happening?
This journal was supposed to be for you. But now I hope you'll never see it. I just want to meet you. I can tell you all these stories myself. But I guess if you're reading this now, things didn't work out that way. This is where your story begins. I'm sorry I won't be there to see it. It's a lot to ask, but I don't want you to be sad that I'm gone. I want you to be amazed that any of us ever had a chance to be here at all. Good luck.
Damn. What? No! Was it the lighthouse that got me? Why am I dead as hell? Oh god, alright guys. Well, we now know what remains of Edith Finch. I hope that you guys liked it. It's a very heart-wrenching tale of a lot of death in this family. A whole lot of death. Guys, thank you so much for watching. You can purchase What Remains of Edith Finch and go on your own journey through Steam. Make sure to like and subscribe and share with your pals. Remember, I have dozens of other videos and other happier stories, I suppose, that you could watch. Thank you guys again, and have a great rest of your day. Bye now!